I'm Steve, Mr. MMA Farragher.
And welcome to the third and final episode of the World Championship Full Contact Last Man Standing Lightweight Championship Tournament event. With only two more fights in the quarterfinals, who will make it on to the semis? Is my boy Steven Razor Sharp gonna beat Derek Wilkerson?
Only time will tell. And then you've got James the Bird Dog Birdsley versus Cody Ziemer. This is a classic striker versus grappler. Which form will prevail?
That's right, Steven. That's the way it's been all tournament long. So in tonight's episode, you've got what's up to the quarterfinals, the semis, and then it's time for the main event. That's right, the final fight of the night. Who's going to win it? If you want to find out, don't go anywhere. We've got the last man standing coming up next. All right, Steve, here we are. It is the quarterfinals, and you've got Derek Wilkerson going up against Steven Razor Sharp. This is going to be an awesome fight. Steven Razor Sharp, guy never disappoints. He's going to come out throwing everything that he has at you. And Wilkerson looking good against his fight against Aaron Iriarte.
Yeah, a little behind the scenes for you. Derek Wilkerson couldn't find his mouthpiece, and it took about 5 minutes. Let me tell you something. You're going to fight a guy like Steven Razor Sharp. There are two things you need to bring with you, your A game and your mouthpiece, because you will be missing teeth if you don't have that thing in to protect.
All right, well, here we are, guys, bringing it to the center of the cage. Mr. Dave Siljestad's going to make this thing official. And look, there's no love lost between these two. What a stare down right there, Steven.
Steven Razor Sharp loves the stare down. Derek trying to convince him, hey, I am not afraid. Razor wants to let him know, dude, you are really fighting me.
Hey, I wouldn't be surprised, though, to see Derek Wilkerson. He's got, once again, he's got nothing to lose. Steven Razor Sharp, I think, has been the favorite in this tournament, or one of the favorites in the tournament. And when we told Derek that he could have the opportunity to fight Steven, he goes, awesome. Oh, man, that would be great. I would love to fight a guy like Steven Sharp. He is a legend around these parts. He's beat up a lot of people. Hell, he's even beat up some of my friends inside of the cage. I'd like to fight this cat.
Absolutely, you know, and there you see Derek going for the takedown. Razor, oh, my gosh, his foot!
Through the fence right there. His foot is through the fence, and I'm not sure what happened.
It almost looks broken.
Don't tell me that it's broken. Nope, back up. Steve's good.
You have got to be kidding me.
Steve's ready to go. He's good.
I have never seen that in my life.
Punched right through the fence right there, but Steve's good. He wants to fight. Don't stop his momentum. He's good. The tape's good. The peak looks great. And he's ready to fight. Let's just let him go. Look at him. Yeah, let's do it. Dave, let's get this fight out of the way. Got you money. Get out of the ring. We got the doc in the ring. Get him out of there.
All right, get me some oxygen for a minute so I can calm down. Wow. You know what? That rallied the crowd. Them seeing that happen and Razor just pop up, this crowd is going nuts.
Well, I don't know what's going on right now, but let's get this thing going. The momentum has to happen right here, but you see right here an instant replay. Foot goes right through the fence. That is
right in front of us, and I'm telling you, when I first saw it, I thought that his foot or ankle was broken.
No, he's good, man. He's fine. Steve's played soccer his whole life, man. Those legs are fine. That kid can kick a wood fence down.
That guy can go through a fence. Apparently.
You know what I like about Steve? Watch when he punches, how fast his hands are. I mean, he never just throws, you know, one punch. He's always looking to follow it up with a kick or another strike. But he loves to throw those punches and land them, man. Knock his opponent out.
Yeah, Wilkerson throwing a lot of leg kicks. Oop, there you see Razor. Going for a guillotine?
Does he have it here? Does the Razor have it? No, he does not have it. And now he's throwing elbows from underneath, and Derek Wilkerson's going to stand over him. And look at the windmill kick by Razor Sharp.
Yeah, going for that guillotine. He gave up position now on his back, but he is not going to let Wilkerson get close to him.
He hopped right back up onto his feet, and Derek's throwing big bombs. Landing a couple right there. That's what he needs to do. Derek Wilkerson needs to close the distance with Steve Sharp. Don't stand outside. Don't let Steve find his range, because when he does, he's going to hit you with fists, elbows, knees, and feet. He's going to do it all.
Well, and even though Derek Wilkerson has watched Razor fight for a long time and, you know, really admires him, he's given himself that chance by throwing big punches.
Great job right there. Derek Wilkerson bouncing off of the cage and then getting a takedown, but Steve immediately back up on his feet. Looks like he's working. A wizard. Oh, and a big knee right there to the solar plexus of Derek Wilkerson. Nice leg kick.
and Stephen Sharp landing some big shots. Another huge knee.
Oh,
and that did it. He is out. Wilkerson is out cold. He's out cold.
Wow. What a knee. You know what? Faces were not made to be kneed. I'm not even sure if Derek knows where he is at.
No, I just read his lips and he said,
wow.
Yeah, wow.
I just got knocked into next week. Wow. Dude, he ate a knee. That was classic Muay Thai. You see right here in the replay. Boom. And then he hits him with a shot on the way down. Go send that to your mama.
And Dave Sellius saved him from one more. Look at this. He's diving.
Oh, man.
Dan Henderson, you know, Michael Bisping style.
Look at that knee. Just crushed him. Clips him with a little forehead shot there. And he does connect on that last one, but not as hard as he would have. But he wants to come over, congratulate Steve Sharp, and send it inside to Tim to make this thing official.
And you know, these guys came in here to put on a show, and a show is what you got. That knee found its target at 2 minutes, 22 seconds of the round. Your winner by knockout, Steven Razor Sharp.
Hey, one more time, round of applause to Derek Wilkerson, showing some love. Great job, man. What about Steven Razor Sharp? Ending it. Ending the fight how Steven Razor Sharp likes to end a fight. Man, you got the knockout. Big knee. Moving on. How do you feel?
I'm finishing fights. That's the whole point. Come in here, fight, finish the fight. I'm not looking to have you or you score any of my fights, all right? So don't do it. I gotta thank my sponsors. I gotta thank my gym, Absolute MMA. Thank you for getting me ready for this tournament. I gotta tell everyone to come to my after party at Southern Exposure. I'm gonna get drunk, and I'm gonna get all you guys drunk with me, all right? And let's fight!
Steve, well, let's just keep the action moving right along. This is the last fight here in the quarterfinals before we get to the semis. There's two fighters about to step inside of the cage. Only one of them is moving on. You've got Cody Ziemer versus the Bird Dog, James the Bird Dog Birdsley.
Wow, this is a great matchup. Cody Ziemer, striking is just so good. Takedown defense is so good. Bird Dog got a pretty good chin. Good wrestling. I don't see this fight going to a decision.
Well, either way, we're in for a treat here in the quarterfinals. Let's let Tim Hughes bring these guys out to the cage.
5 minutes to advance to the semifinals and one step closer to that $5,000 and a title belt in the lightweight division of the WCFC. Give these ladies a big hand as they make their way around the cage here for you tonight.
Oh, once again, the Bird Dog says, no touching the gloves. I just want to punch your face. And that's the way to start it. Here we are. It is the last quarterfinal fight before we move on into the semis. What's going to happen here, Steve?
You know, sometimes, though, you don't touch those gloves. It'll light a fire under the guy you're fighting. Wow.
And right there, Cody Ziemer just kicked the legs out from under the Bird Dog, and he is on him relentlessly, landing big shots. He's got the back of the Bird Dog, hitting him with everything he has. Looks like he buckled him right there, shot after shot after shot. Wow.
Oh, my goodness. Bird Dog, I don't even know how Bird Dog is still standing.
Well, he took some big shots, no doubt about it, but he was still on his feet, covering up and, you know, protect yourself at all times. Birdsley was doing that. I didn't see him drop. I just saw him protect himself. Wow, great job, James Birdsley, for weathering that freaking vicious storm.
No, great job, but it just shows you how, you know, in the first fight, I wanted Cody to be a little more aggressive. We immediately saw that for the second fight. Good side kick.
Yeah, a little step-up sidekick right there. Got the distance on Birdsley. But look at that stance of Zimmer. It hasn't changed. Both fights, he's just been tucked in, landing the big, solid shots. Oh, and a nice body kick to Birdsley. And you saw a buckle him. That hurt him. That hurt him.
When the hands drop and you immediately shoot, you know you got him with a good one. And,
he's off to the side a little bit here, Steve. He's off to the side. He's against the fence, but he had that choke. No arm encircled. He had a classic guillotine. But James Birdsley, not moving. He's still pressing him against the fence here, looking for that takedown. And Zimmer's got that one-armed guillotine going.
Yeah, you know, Zimmer needs to be a little careful because he doesn't quite have the position to get that. Needs to make sure he's not squeezing too much. Doesn't want to burn himself out.
Which we've seen happen in fights. You know, guys will get on that bottom position. They'll hold on to that head, and they just won't let go, thinking they're going to get that submission. I don't think Cody, I think he's a lot smarter fighter than that. So I don't think that's going to happen. But right here, both these guys end up back on their feet. Birdsley throwing a big knee that just misses, and then kind of a weird little combination to work that takedown.
Yeah, but again, in Zimmer's first fight, you never saw him on his back. Bird Dog doing a good job of, you know, closing the distance, trying to get those takedowns.
Yeah, but is this going to tire Birds out? You know, that's one of the things that Birdsley told me, though. He said, my cardio, my conditioning is on point right now. It's absolutely the best shape that I've ever been in. I'm running Mount Olympus three times a day. Like, I just feel like my gas tank is endless. I didn't say it just like that. He kind of said, I'm the Bird Dog, and my gas tank's endless. I'm going to kill you.
I get gas for free. But you know what? This is the second time we've seen Zimmer on his back. Now, an interesting thing, you know, going along with what you were saying is Bird Dog is from Utah. Zimmer's from Idaho. That altitude difference, you know, could play a part.
Well, Bird Dog's hit him with a couple shots right there to the side of the head. And now Zimmer looks like maybe he's a little bit injured here. Did something happen to him? Did we miss a shot, or he's just getting beat on right now?
Big punch.
Bird Dog is now landing some body shots here, and in a great position right here to just really rain down some shots. And if we know James Birdsley, that's exactly what he's going to do. Now, we've seen this exact position before. He gets his opponent right up into the cage and uses it so well. I'm going to tell you, James Birdsley used to train at Jeremy Horn's Elite Performance, and there's one thing that those guys do excellent is use this cage as a tool in the fight.
No, they definitely learn the best on that. Now at pit elevated, working with some of the guys over there. But Bird Dog in a very dominant position.
Looks like he may be setting up what could be an arm bar. He's got the fence right behind him right there, but that's what you do. Now he's got the back of Cody Zimmer, flattened him out. We haven't seen this out of Cody Zimmer. Big shots right there to the face. All he's doing is got his hand up. He's trying to protect him. He's out. He's out.
Oh my gosh. Cody Zimmer, the machine, who, you know, many, including myself, thought, God, this guy has as good a chance as anybody. The Bird Dog with the biggest upset
just
so far.
Got stopped by the Bird Dog. Hey, Bird Dog's back, baby. The Bird Dog is for real. He is moving on to the semis. You know who I hope he fights? You know who I hope we get a chance to see him fight? Steven Razor Sharp, the rubber match. We need to see it. What do we got to do? Let's hope it happens. But he's moving on.
Hide your kids. Hide your wife. The Bird Dog is in town.
That's right.
And going with what you said, him against Razor
would be amazing.
That is a fight.
It's the rubber match. We need to see it. But here you go in the highlights right here. James Birdsley landing huge, huge shots. Oh, Birdsley, congratulations. Let's send it to Tim Hughes. Let's make this thing official.
He was in trouble there at the beginning of the round, but this one ends with an official time. 3:45. When referee Dave Sellius steps in to wave it off, ruled a technical knockout by referee stoppage, your winner, James Birdsley.
All right, well, there you have it. The quarterfinals are done. Steven Razor Sharp pulls off a victory. James the Bird Dog Birdsley does what he does best, finds a way to win. Woo! Can't believe it, man. We're moving on to the semifinals.
Props to the WCFC for making that rubber match happen. These guys have already fought. Each has won one fight. Who's going to win in the rubber match? And then you have a great matchup between Lucas Montoya and Talon Hoffman, who's kind of been the dark horse of the tournament. We're going to find out who's got the best ground game in that fight.
That's right. And if you want more semifinal action, well, don't go anywhere. We're going to go to commercial. But when we come back, it's the start of the semis. We'll be right back.
welcome back to the WCFC. I am Johnny Ricci hanging out with Steve, Mr. MMA Farragher. Steve, we have been treated to some of the best mixed martial arts I have ever seen in the Western United States, if not, period. I feel like I'm the luckiest man alive. I'm getting paid to sit here and watch these fights when it's been nothing but nonstop action from start to finish. It is now time for the semifinals. This is going to be an amazing round of fights. Steven Farragher, what do you know about the athletes that are going to be making their way to the cage here momentarily?
Well, this I can tell you. They call me Mr. MMA because it's all I watch. I love this sport, but I could not tell you which of these four guys is going to win the tournament. All of them are fighting so good, laying it all out there. This is anyone's tournament to be won.
All right, well, let's send it up to Tim Hughes right now. Tim, get these fighters to the cage.
He's a wrestler, but a good overall mixed martial artist. 5 feet 10, 157 and one half pounds. Fighting here tonight from Boise, Idaho, please make him feel welcome, Talon Hoffman. He hails from Ogden, Utah. He comes to the Rail Event Center tonight to win it all. Here comes Lucas Montoya.
All right, well, here we go, man. Bring these guys to the center of the cage. Dave Silly said is your third man inside of the cage, going over the last minute little regulations and rules that we have. Make sure you just don't grab the fence. Dave does not like that. And make sure that you press the action. This is the semis, baby, and they're underway.
Dave Silly instead.
Wow, this is going to be a very interesting fight. Talon Hoffman has done a great job with positioning and, you know, beating some of the guys, but their mutual opponent that they have, Lucas, was able to finish where Talon went to a decision.
Well, here's the deal. If it wasn't for the tattoos, I couldn't tell these two apart because they're like virtually identical. They're both fit. They're both the same fighter. We've seen mirror images of these guys inside of their own separate fights. They look a lot alike. They fight a lot alike. This could be one of the most exciting matchups in the world going on right now.
Yeah, you see Lucas has Talon pressed up against Cage. It's the takedown. I don't think we've seen Talon fight off his back much yet.
We haven't, and I tell you what, Lucas has been able to take down every single opponent at will. Whenever he needed the takedown, it was there for him. Now, is it the fact, too, that he's probably one of the larger fighters? Oh, but you see right there, working for that ankle lock, didn't get it, but he had that thing for just a second. I thought he was going to snap that foot off.
Yeah, you know, I really like that because it's a really aggressive move to go for it. Unfortunately, he gave up a lot of position going for that move.
Wait, what does he got right now? Looks like he's working in a triangle. He's working on the arm bar. He's got to get that leg sunk in just a little bit more, but it looks like he's got it. There's the arm bar. He's cranking on it right now. Is he going to get it?
Oh,
there's a tap.
Lucas Montoya has tapped Talon Hoffman.
Look at the smile on that guy's face. You know where he's going, Steve? Straight to the finals. We've got the first half of your finals bracket match right there. Lucas Montoya beats Talon Hoffman in a decisive submission. Triangle into armbar, cranked on it, Talon tap. Your man, Lucas Montoya, moving on.
Well, and I was just chastising Lucas for the aggression he used going for that ankle lock, but he uses that same aggression to go for the triangle, not only a triangle, but doing the armbar as well. Great job, Lucas.
Wow, Lucas Montoya, buddy. We talked about him in the very beginning, do you remember? And said, this is one of the guys you want to watch. You want to watch this kid because he's doing all the right things. Well, now he finds himself in the finals. The bird dog or Steven Razor Sharpen, either way, it's going to be one hell of a main event and one hell of a final move. Let's send it inside the TV right now. Let's make this thing official. Congratulations, Lucas Montoya.
We've got an official initial time of 1 minute 27 seconds. Looked like it might go by way of a triangle, but ended up in an arm bar and a tap out. Moving on, Lucas Montoya.
All right, well, there he is, Steve Farragher. You called it, man. Lucas Montoya, what a stud. Moving on into the finals. I can't wait to hear what this kid has to say about moving on to the finals. I'm going to go up right now and talk to him.
Wow, guys, hats off, man. Right there, Talon Hoffman. Come on, give him some love. Coming from Boise. Representing Dragon Bushido. But how about your winner, Lucas Montoya. Lucas, another one bites the dust. Here we are in the finals, man. You know, you got a, like I said, you got a great team. You're confident. You feel good. Your conditioning is great. Are you going to win this thing?
Oh, man, I sure hope so. I got a lot of people here. They're going to be mad if I lose.
Well, Lucas, I love your strategy. You come in, you fight hard. We've seen a little bit of everything from you tonight. You get a submission, you end the fight. Moving on into the finals, would you rather fight Sharp or Birdsley?
Man, I love both those guys. They're both badass fighters, so whoever it is going to be a war, so let's get it on.
Well, I tell you what, we're excited to see you one more time. Moving on into the finals, it's Lucas Montoya!
Welcome back to the WCFC City Cage Side. Johnny Ritchie here with Steve, Mr. MMA Farragher, in what has been an excellent night of mixed martial arts action inside the cage here at the Rail Event Center in beautiful downtown Salt Lake City, Utah. It is the semifinals. We have Steven Razor Sharp facing James the Bird Dogs Birdsley. These guys have fought twice before, each one of them with the victory. This is the rubber match, Steve Farragher. What is going to happen in this fight?
You know, it's tough to say. Their very first fight, Razor caught Bird Dog in the head with a head kick. You know, quickly after, TKO victory. Second fight, you know, was a back and forth battle in the first round. But in the second, Bird Dog was able to finish Razor. Third fight, we will know who is the best of these two fighters.
Well, I tell you what, I couldn't be more amped up. I have my fingers crossed that this fight was going to happen at some point tonight, and it is here. Let's bring these fighters out to the cage. Shaking hands or touching gloves. As you see by this stare down, they do not like each other at all. They want to not only win, but they want to beat the crap out of each other. And hopefully, we get a chance to see these guys get after it.
No, a lot of history behind these two guys. Razor coming out very aggressive.
Coming out, firing shots. Birdsley with a head kick right there that missed. Razor did a good job of moving out of the way. Like I said, James Birdsley, one of the stronger 155ers in the state. Look at this kid. Look how much bigger he even looks than Steve Sharp. You know, Birdsley's cutting from 80 almost to get down to 55. And the day of the fight, he looks like it.
Well, and Razor, you know, for his third fight, he is still very quick. He is throwing very fast, quick.
Oh,
big right.
Big right hand. Oh, my. He caught him.
Dropped the
right
bird.
The chin dropped him. But look at James Birdsley. Look at the composure on this guy. Able to get away from the, shake the cobwebs off and grab Steve's leg, looking for a takedown. Steve is in a zone, man. The Razor is in a zone.
Oh, how is Bird Dog still conscious?
Dude, it's James Birdsley, man. Like, there's not, dude, as far as toughness goes.
Oh, my God.
Did you just see that? He punched him in the shoulder, and he knocked his shoulder out of socket. I've never seen that.
I have never seen that in my life. Hopefully, Bird Dog is okay, but Steven Razor Sharp hit him with a hook in the shoulder, and his arm's dislocated.
You see right there. Look at right there. His arm is out of place. Steven Razor Sharp just knocked Birdsley's arm out of socket with a strike. That's a way. Hey, I've heard of tap outs. I've heard of knockouts, TKOs. But to knock a guy's shoulder out with a punch, are you kidding me?
Oh, see, you see the strike to the head, and then bam, right there was on the arm. That is what dislocated it.
You gotta be joking me. Well, guess what? It sets up the final. Steven Razor Sharp versus Lucas Montoya. Who is the baddest 155er in the Western United States? Well, we're gonna find out soon. Let's send it in to Tim Hughes to make this thing official.
Ladies and gentlemen, it happened again. Lightning has struck twice, and I think if you do total time in the cage tonight, Sharp might actually have the least amount of time in the cage. This one comes to an end 1 minute, 4 seconds into the round, and it comes to an end by way of strikes. Steven Razor Sharp!
All right, guys, whether you love him or hate him, let's get a round of applause to James Birdsley, man. Awesome performance. James, we hope you're okay. Might have blown his shoulder out, but Steve, get over here. What about the Razor? All right, Steven, this is it. You and Lucas Montoya in the finals. Man, oh, man, what an awesome matchup. Striker versus grappler. I know that Lucas was... We talked, he said, man, if there's anybody I would like to fight in the finals, it would be Steve Sharp. We're gonna bang, we're gonna put on a show for the crowd. Is it gonna happen in the finals tonight?
First of all, I gotta thank all you guys. This has been such an amazing event for me, for the production. Thanks to everyone for coming out. And those that missed it, you are missing some fights. Man, I wish these damn things counted on my record. And I think because I'm finishing them, they should count on my record instead of letting it go to a judge's decision. Because it didn't matter if it was a championship fight. I'm finishing fights right now. I got to take my hat off to James Birdsley. I actually respect James a lot more than people know. I knew that fighting him, I would have to pick my moments to attack. And I couldn't rush in. He's a strong wrestler. James is a great fighter. And I was stoked to get the rubber match. And people have been talking about that fight for
years.
Goddamn, like 7 years. So thank you, James Birdsley, for giving me that opportunity. And tonight was my night, but maybe next time it's yours. Who knows? But tonight, I'm done. I'm gonna beat the hell out of Lucas Montoya and I'm out of here. Give me the belt.
All right, well there it is. It's all coming up next. The finals coming up.
All right, well, the semifinals are done. They're over with. We know who's moving on to the finals. And let's start with my boy, Steven Razor Sharp. Does what he does best against James Birdsley, and that's beat the competition down. Steven Razor Sharp, moving on to the finals.
Yeah, he hit Birdsley so hard, he knocked his shoulder out. Lucas Montoya, he wins his fight the old-fashioned way, using an armbar. It's time to see who's gonna get that gold.
Well, I tell you what, man, it's about that time. It's the finals. Steven Razor Sharp versus Lucas Montoya. Coming up next.
It is the championship fight. It's all come down to this. The winners, the losers. This is it. Steven Razor Sharp versus Lucas Montoya. Steve, Mr. MMA Farragher, this is going to be a fight for the ages. They take home the cash. They take home the belt. And they take home the pride of being the WCFC champion. This is going to be amazing.
My name is Lucas Montoya. I'm 24 years old. Come out of Ogden, Utah. I train at Lobato MMA, West Side, Dave Foley's, everywhere that takes me that has tough guys, I go, man. My MMA record is 6-3, and my fighting style is primarily jiu-jitsu, but I love boxing, man, so I'll stand and bang with anybody. You know what, I actually didn't like MMA when I first started. I did jiu-jitsu, and the first time I went boxing, I got punched in the nose and I left. And I thought, man, I'm never gonna do this again, so, but just slowly kind of grows on you. I had a talent for it. My trainer pushed me, and first time I got in the cage, I got my ass kicked, but I won, and so that I think that's where the love really came, was my first victory. So fireworks, man, I'm not gonna go to the judges. It's 5 minutes, and one of us is going out with our hand up, and one's going out with their hand down. I'd rather lose trying to win than win trying not to lose, so that's where we're gonna be.
My name's Steven Razor Sharp, I'm 31, yeah, I'm old. Fighting out of Absolute MMA in Salt Lake City, Utah. My fight style is more just whatever it takes to beat you up. I like to punch people, but if you look at my record, I'm more of a submission fighter, so either way you're gonna be entertained. And record, I don't know, they're for DJs. What got me into MMA is watching my buddy Robert Densley and my other now buddy, Johnny Ritchie, brawling. Watching those two fight, I figured, hell, if Robert can do it, I can do it. So stepped in the cage and kind of shadowed Robert, and then took it to the next level. I've been training hard, a lot of stand-up, a lot of wrestling, takedown defense. I want to keep all these fights on their feet. I want to punch people. I want to hurt them. Whether I win or lose, I don't care. You're going to see more of an old school Stephen Sharp fighter.
The winners, the losers, this is it. Stephen Razor Sharp versus Lucas Montoya. Steve, Mr. MMA Farragher, this is going to be a fight for the ages. They take home the cash, they take home the belt, and they take home the pride of being the WCFC champion. This is gonna be amazing.
This place is electric. Everybody, by the end of the night, has picked one of the two, who they're gonna root behind. Is it Montoya? Is it Sharp? This place is divided. We're gonna find out soon.
Well, Dave Silly said, going over the last official rules with these guys, making sure they understand, and there is the steely-eyed, cold-blooded killer look coming from Steven Razor Sharp. But Lucas Montoya says, let's do it. Let's bring it on. I've waited for the opportunity to fight you, Steve, for a long, long time. You being a legend, me being the new pup on the block, I want this fight, I want this victory, I want that belt. With a touch of the glove, Stephen Farragher, this thing is underway.
Well, and conventional wisdom would tell you that for Lucas to win this fight, he's gonna need to submit Razor, and for Razor to win this fight, he's gonna need to knock Lucas out.
Yeah, without a doubt, Lucas Montoya been able to impose his will all in every single fight that he had. He was able to get multiple takedowns against multiple opponents. He's going up against Stephen Sharp, who's got great takedown defense, but more dangerous are Steve's strikes. If you get inside, he is gonna land the shots that will put you on your can, so you have to move quick, you have to move fast, you have to close that distance to get that takedown.
And we haven't talked about it a lot tonight, but Razor has over 40 fights. He's never been knocked out.
Never been knocked out, never. Oh, but right there, we talked about it. Did Lucas get the takedown? You better believe that he did. Now, what does he do with the takedown? Look at Stephen Sharp. He knows that if he stalls out right here, Dave is gonna stand him up, and that's exactly what Steve wants. Smart fighting on the part of Stephen Razor Sharp.
No, very, very good, you know, strategy on his part. Still, Lucas able to improve his position.
Now, we've seen Lucas in this position all night with almost every single guy that he fought. He would step into this half guard position, work his opponent into the fence, and then cram him with elbows and fists until the opponent either tapped out or wasn't able to continue.
Lucas
and,
is bleeding out of that nose.
He is bleeding out of that. He got racked there, something good. Probably by an elbow from Stephen Razor Sharp. Steve is one of those guys that will just go bananas from the bottom position. He'll elbow, he'll punch, he'll do whatever that he has to do. And right here, he's just holding on just for long enough that Dave Silly said will stop this fight from inactivity.
Well, and you saw him, looking up at the ref like, come on, come on, I'm tying him up.
Yep, and there it is, Stephen Razor Sharp chess match right here. Ties up Lucas Montoya, just about 3 minutes on the clock. And this is it, this is your last round. The people are on their feet, going absolutely crazy. The crowd is split down the middle, half for Lucas, half for Steven. Oh man, Steve, it couldn't get any better than this main event fight right here in your championship match.
Well, and very dangerous for Lucas because he's bleeding out of his nose. He's probably having to breathe out of his mouth. And keeping that chin open can make you more susceptible for the knockout.
A la Ninja right there. Steve Sharp, every time he throws a kick or that punch misses, he puts his hands up in the air and says, hey, you know, let's do this, brother.
Yeah, he loves Shogun Hua.
Shogun. I think I said Ninja, but
that's
Shogun.
Right.
Oh, but that's, oh, man! And a big knee by Lucas Montoya as it drives Steve Sharp back into the cage. This is what Lucas wants. He wants this.
Is that a gate? Oh, my gosh! Steven Razor Sharp submits Lucas Montoya.
We thought it was going to be a knockout. We thought it was going to be a TKO. But what does Steven do? He submits Lucas Montoya. I'm almost at a loss for words.
Not in a million years would I have picked Razor to beat Montoya by submission. But he caught him in a tight guillotine.
Wow.
Lucas tapped almost immediately. Your champion.
There's your champion, Steven Razor Sharp. What a submission, as you see right here in the highlights. Lucas hits Steven with the big knee, goes for the takedown, and Steve locks this guillotine up from the start, and it is tight. Throws the leg up over the shoulder, and he's cranking on that thing until Dave stops. He says, I want the belt. I'm not letting go. I'm going, this is it. I've got it. I've got to have the submission. He gets it. He wins. Steven Razor Sharp, your champion.
Unbelievable. What a night of fights. This place is going nuts. Steven Razor Sharp couldn't be any happier, and what a deserving champion.
An amazing night of fights put on by the WCFC. Once again, hats off to all the guys behind the scenes. You know, Shane Traveler, Joe Wooten, Sean Baywick, all the guys, John Midget. There's been a bunch of guys behind the scenes putting this thing together, and I tell you what, this has probably been one of the coolest nights of mixed martial arts I've ever been a part of. Man, if you missed this event live, you missed out. Go to WCFC.com for more information about fights coming up. And let's send it inside the cage to Tim Hughes, the voice, the velvet voice of MMA.
Yeah, what a way to end the night. And an unconventional front guillotine is what ended this one at 2 minutes, 38 seconds of the round. Your winner and the champion of this 16-man tournament, Steven Razor Sharp.
All right, guys, let's give him a round of applause to Lucas Montoya.
Lucas, I'm so proud of you, man. Everybody here, you got a lot of people rooting for you tonight. You go up against Steve Sharp, and I think this is a fight that a lot of fans have wanted to see for a long, long time. But you showed your heart out there, man. You guys were banging, and there was a couple times you landed some shots, and I know Steve felt them. But needless to say, man, it didn't work out for you tonight. Tell me, how do you feel about the tournament and about coming in second place to a guy like Steve Sharp?
There was a lot of tough guys here tonight, so second place is pretty damn good.
Absolutely, man, absolutely. Once again, Lucas, you're a tough, tough guy. You're so young in the sport. You're going to continue to get better and better and better. And we love you at the WCFC. You can knock guys out and you can submit them in a second. I just want to say congratulations to you for making it this far. What comes next?
Oh, man, some more fights. Let me get back into training, work on some stuff, and I'll be back.
Well, you heard it right there. Let's get a round of applause to Lucas Montoya. All right, now it's time for your winner of the WCFC 16-man Last Man Standing Tournament, Steven Razor Sharp. I think my boy Joe Wooten got a nice little belt put across your waist right there. Joe Wooten, CEO of the WCFC. Put that belt across his waist, man, right there. There it is. Over the shoulder. Get a round of applause to the Razor! Steve, once again, man, fantastic job. You got in here and, you did what Steven Razor Sharp does, and that's rise to the occasion. You fought a lot of tough guys. There are a lot of tough guys in this tournament. But you prevailed. You've got the belt. You got the check.
What comes next?
Man, I'm a pussy. I want to cry right now.
No, do it!
I appreciate first the WCFC for putting this on. It's kind of funny that this was kind of my idea. And it's a great tournament. I hope we do more of them. And I'm looking forward to defending my belt. I'm pretty positive I broke my hand against Bird Dog. And that last fight was really a challenge of
your heart.
Of my heart. And I'm still punching him. I threw that first uppercut that blasted him with my broken hand. And it hurt me probably more than it hurt him. But I got to take my hat off to every single one of the guys that fought, not only the guys that I fought, but just to everyone for making this a wonderful night. For me, and I hope it was for everyone else too, everyone that came here. I got to thank my sponsors. My gym comes first, Absolute MMA, Rockwell, No Weak Links, Willow Creek Chiropractic. I had my chiropractor and my massage therapist back there giving me rub downs and adjustments in between fights, so thank you to them. Southern Exposure again. I can't drink $400 worth of alcohol, and I'm a two-shot guy. So if you guys make me drink all these drinks, I'm gonna be really upset, because last time I threw up a shit ton. So, last thing I gotta do is we gotta plank.
These guys are gonna do a little plank action right here. Once again, your winner, Steven Razor Sharp!
Congratulations, man. We're proud of you. You did it. And Steve, I'll be seeing you defending this belt very, very soon.
I needed that check so bad. You guys don't even know, man. I'm going through some of the worst financial trouble I've had. And that's mainly the reason why I'm going to cry. Not because of the competition, not because it was a hell of a night, but I'm hurting financially.
Well, not anymore. Your winner, Steven Razor Sharp.